Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another No Money Spent video here on my channel. Now, only the one this week, right? Like, I usually upload two. I'll explain a bit more in just a few moments on that. But today, we've got more of a chill No Money Spent. We're gonna go over some stuff. We're gonna talk about my new lineup. Of course, it's now May. I don't know how, like, this year is flying by. But we've got a new 12-0 player. We're gonna look at those stats. I'm gonna show you the lineup I'm gonna try and go 12-0 with, man. In addition, we're gonna look at some of the new content today because there was some very interesting content that dropped on this Friday. And we will get to some locker codes as well, because there's a bunch I've missed. Maybe some of you guys have missed them as well. So why don't we get into it, right? Now, first things first, the reason I've only put out one No Money Spent this video and why this one's not going to be like unbelievable or anything is because I've only been doing one thing on this account, one thing only, and that's Spotlight Sims. So I've completed the whole East. I locked in, got Pascal Siakam. I'm almost done the West of the originals. And in terms of the historics, I've already knocked off 9 of these. So in case you missed my tweet yesterday, I'm officially halfway done, which seems like it's not very much, but you know what, bro? Like, I want that Kobe, even if it takes me, you know, another 2-3 weeks, it's gonna happen. I don't care if I'm not the first or the 9,000th person to finish, you know? I think this Kobe will be worth it, so I'm gonna keep grinding away. It's just, yeah, I didn't have a chance to play triple threat this week or do any sniping. Like, it's just these spotlight sim cards, but I'm kind of okay with that. I'm enjoying it as I go. But before we get into any of the new content or my new lineup that I built, here's a look at Glenn Rice Opal card. If you haven't seen it yet, he is the new unlimited player of the month. Now, obviously stats, I mean, he is juiced. The only thing under 80 on this card is his rebounding stats, which are actually pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. Shooting guard, small forward, 6'7", like, this dude's a freak. Galaxy Opal T-Mac, basically, he's on that level, which is really sweet. I mean, you do have to win 12 games for him, which is the struggle, but you know. Badge-wise, this card is everything. I don't care too much about the finishing badges, but shooting-wise, I mean, he's got Hall of Fame Deadeye, Quick Draw, Range Extender, Catch and Shoot, I'm sure is in there somewhere. I can't remember the base number of his jumper, but it's the Dwayne Wade jump shot. I've seen animations. It is unbelievable. He's got such a great jump shot. Playmaking badges, I mean, handles for days is just overkill on a shooting card like this. Like, he can also handle the ball, clamps, intimidator. This card looks perfect. He really, really does. And I need him, man. I need him badly in my life. Plus, Glenn Rice played for like 7 different teams in his career. So like, all-time team, say what's up for this. And obviously, here's a look at Glenn Rice in Unlimited. I wonder what the other card is you get with him. Oh, Dirk. Wait, and Clyde? Oh, that's what's up. So wait, if I beat 12-0 this month and I got Dirk and Clyde, I would be, I would still need the Amari to get that Opal Julius Erving, which would be cool. That Opal Erving is a pretty good card. We're also now one card closer to whatever this mystery collection is. So yeah, I mean, obviously we want to get Glenn Rice this month. And I will show you in a little bit. We're still going to do some stuff before the lineup I'm going to start with to try and get 12-0 Glenn Rice. Now, as you guys know, sometimes I have to cheese for it. Sometimes I have to do other things. I'm definitely not going to start playing Unlimited for a couple days because the streets are going to be so cancerous. But yeah, we'll go over that in a bit. But first, we got some locker codes, fellas. Now, make sure you guys are tuning in, checking out the My Team Twitter page. This is where you find all of them because I'm not showing everyone that's come out in the last week, just the ones I missed. Now, this one is for Amethyst Kevin Rant. Oh, I just skipped past the code again. Check the My Team Twitter page. I always forget to show it. I just hit enter. Low-key, this Amethyst KD is cool just for like the nostalgia, but I would almost rather have the chance at Galaxy Opal KD from the pack. Like, bah, I know I'm not gonna pull it, so whatever. Just give me whatever here. And looks like we do actually get the pack, so we'll see if we can't find something Galaxy Opal KD-ish, maybe. I don't know. That would be funny. Trust me, I have no expectations here. It's probably gonna be a silver. If I get a gold from this pack, gold player, like, that's a W based on the standards they have set. So, let's see. I really got a silver, bro. Well, in hindsight, I definitely would have rather got the Amethyst KD. That hurts. Okay, on to the next one. I'm not going to hit enter really quickly here. I know it, okay? So this one's actually pretty interesting because it guarantees you something. I'm not going to say fire, but reasonable. Pink, diamonds, and diamonds. The board looks like this, man. We got Wilt. We got current series 2 Anthony Davis, Diamond Joel Embiid. I mean, none of these cards are going to sell for a lot. Diamond Lamar Odom, which is ironic. I guess I want the Wilt, although I don't think he sells for a lot either. So again, just I'll take whatever it lands in. And it does indeed land in the Wilt. Okay. I think that's probably the most expensive one. I mean, he maybe goes for like 10, 15K if I'm not mistaken. So we'll take it. I'll actually hold on to him for a bit because his price has probably dipped with this locker code. Last one for today is another another chance at some packs, which, man, I say this every time I make one of these videos, like, eventually I'll get blessed from a locker code. I haven't yet. I've got blessed from other packs, of course, on this season, on this account, I should say, in this series, but never the locker codes. Maybe today is my day. Prime-1-Prime-2-Mate. All right, we got it? Okay, go to the Twitter page, I say again. What is this board looking like, my guys? Okay, so we got a Kristaps pack, a John Stock. Wait, what? Okay, I only want the Kristaps pack. The other packs are all, they're all series one, man. Okay, how do we get this Kristaps pack? Okay, get out of there. Get out of there. I don't want the Tim Duncan pack. Wait, Tim Duncan actually sells for a lot, doesn't he? I remember somebody tweeted me that he sells for a lot. Give me the Tim Duncan pack. Sure, why not? I swear I saw somebody tweet the other day that they pulled a Tim Duncan from Triple Threat online, like a free pack, and he sells for a bunch. So let's go. I just remembered that I'm gonna get a bronze card. Yeah. Oh, dang it. I thought that was a pink diamond. I'm just colorblind. Like, it is what, they give me a Spurs player too. Oh, that's just disrespectful. This is Bruce Bowen, isn't it? I guess it makes sense. He was in that collection, but still, that kind of hurts. I'm not gonna lie. Now, here's the thing, fellas. I'd love to look up some cards for you today and show you the prices of stuff. And this is also prohibiting my ability to build my best lineup today. But as I'm recording this video, the auction house is glitched. See, it's only showing cards from 2.5 hours left. That is this glitch that's been happening so frequently lately. Like, you can't see recent cards popping up. Now, apparently 2K says they're working on it. I literally don't believe them because this glitch has been happening for like weeks. And the problem is everybody who had auctions that were ending like at this exact moment I'm recording this video, people can't see their cards. So they're going for like nothing. It's so bad. I got ripped off on my other account for this exact glitch. But yeah, like if I try going to look up this Wilt Chamberlain just to see what he's worth now, it'll probably only show me cards ending. Yeah, 2.5 hours. Like, I guarantee there's more recent cards. So I have no idea what to list them for. This is just a mess, dude. It is really a mess. And it's one of the reasons I can't actually see what these new cards are going for. Okay, so today they dropped Danny Granger, Lamar Odom. Both those cards are gonna be fire, especially this Lamar Odom. I've already seen some gameplay. Like, he is, yeah, he's great. But in addition, they slid in an Eddie Curry and George Mirazan. And let me tell you, we're gonna look at these Curry badges. They gave him base 38 jumper, which is the same one my guy Bingo Smith has. This card looks stupid. He is absolutely gonna be on my team. Not today, because I mentioned the auction house is broken. Like, I can't buy him at a reasonable price or pretty much any price. I don't know what he's selling for, but eventually he is going to be on my team. Absolutely. His card looks that good. Ketino Mobley, Nick Young also looks like a budget beast. Because we're no money spent series, I'm not even going to show you that Lamar Odom and Danny Granger. Like, we know they're going to be stupidly stacked. Like, it is what it is. Now, the auction house currently tells me Eddie Curry is selling for 100K buy now. I don't even know if these cards like are legit. Like, I feel like they might be glitched too, but oh wait, you know what? He is selling, when I was looking like 10 minutes ago, he wasn't even selling for under. I'm probably gonna end up trying to snipe this card because I think people will put him up for less than 100K, even though trust me, boys, like he's worth more than this, I promise you. He's a 7-foot center, 99 offense, 99 defense, 31 Hall of Fame badges, and I'm talking catch and shoot, green machine, shooting badges, quick first step, of course, downhill. He's got clamp so he can switch out, intimidator, and boys, like he just moves. He moves like a guard. It is crazy. The interceptors out there, pick dodger, another bronze or another guard badge, unpluckable, range extender, quick draw. Yeah, this card is a must have. I honestly want to buy him for 96K, but I don't know if that's his real price. Trust me when I say, like, this card will be worth it. Like, even if I bought him for like 95K and his price dipped, you know what? I'm just gonna wait. It's smart for me to wait until the auction house isn't glitched to make sure we get this card at the right price. But yeah, he's absolutely gonna be worth it. But as you guys know, when new content comes out, even though I'm no money spend, bruh, I like to, oh my gosh, I almost forgot. Half of the importance of this video was to me to show you this. Oh my gosh. Okay, hold on. Boys, check out my auction results. I literally almost forgot. I am at 515 KMT right now, but not for long. As I was doing the spotlight series, whatever you call them, challenges, I did Evo a second Pau Gasol. Now, my last one I showed last video sold for 170K. This one, 130K. So I only took like a 10-12K profit, but honestly, I'm okay with it, man. It gave me something to do while I was Evoing those or doing those challenges. So there you go. And also, as you can see, 2 days ago, contracts, diamond contracts, finally recouped in price. So I sold all of mine for 13.5 KMT. Each of these cards I bought for about 9K. So I'm taking like a 3 to 4K profit on every single one. I don't know, contracts might be even more expensive now. I just thought, you know, I see them selling for what would be a profit for me. I'm gonna unload these boys. So my investment finally paid off. I did in fact make a bunch of MT off this. In fact, I eclipsed 800 KMT. Man, that is such a W. You know what? I'm going to look at diamond contract cards. It's going to make me mad if now they're selling for like 15K, but it is what it is, man. Like, I made the decision to sell them off. Oh no, they're pretty much holding steady. 13.5K. Yeah. Okay. I did sell them at a good time. All right. I'll take that W. But as you guys know, when I re-up with some MT like I am now, I'm not gonna be smart about it, okay? I'm gonna do something dumb here, as always. These packs aren't like super enticing to me, so I'm not gonna rip probably as many, but if I could pull this Eddie Curry, I would be very happy. Of course, the Galaxy Opals as well. This George Mirzan, I haven't even looked at this dude's stats. I just know he's 7'7" and gonna be an absolute problem. But one of the reasons, honestly, boys, that I open packs, because I know some people comment like, why don't you just like buy a better team with the MT? Is because yes, I can waste like 100k MT pulling packs with like the hope at getting something good. But what if I spent MT and bought like, I don't know, one of the new Galaxy Opal cards that came out like a week or two ago? By now, their value has dipped. Like, cards are so unpredictable this year. I hate spending MT and having cards just sit in my collection. Like, I hate it. That's why I primarily use the free cards that I grind for, or the really, really nice, like cheap, you know, like an Eddie Curry card that's under 100K. That's why I prefer having them in my collection. And then if I'm going to spend MT, I'm going to waste it on some packs. Because here we go. Galaxy Opal right here in this pack.
Nope.
I thought I could feel it. I really did. And honestly, I'm like, yo, I haven't pulled anything in a while. Those out of position packs last week just ruined me with the odds. Eventually, I've got to get blessed again. Like, it's got to happen sometime here. The locker code packs did not do that. So come on, 2K. Man, a Ruby. Wow. These odds are real tough. I'm not going to lie. Another Russell. Like, I pulled 2 Russell Westbrooks in 5 packs. That does not make sense. But it's all good, you know, my investment paid off. I'm working on another Evo Pau Gasol, so we'll make some MT back there. Yikes, man. I haven't even seen like an Amethyst. Not even my boy, current series 2, Karl-Anthony Towns, who I always get when I open packs. This is tough. This is tough. Just spam the triangle. Oh, I'm so sad. That one took like 2 seconds to reveal. It was hanging there. I was like, is this a diamond? Is this a pink diamond? Is this an opal? And they really get, oh, okay. Well, you know what? This is Swaggy P. Swaggy P's cool, actually. I saw his animations. Yeah, all right, whatever. Maybe it's a sign if I open one more pack, which will bring me under 700 KMT. One more pack will have my Galaxy Opal in it. Here we go. Here we go. Here
I am having a very bad day.
Here we don't go. That's really sad. All right, so those packs were garbage as per usual. Yes, I just wasted a bunch of MT on packs. You guys can get mad at me. I'm not even mad though. All right, Nick Young, what is he, a 6'7" wing player? That's not bad. 26 Hall of Fame badges. I like catch and shoot. I like range extender, clamps, dead eye. Okay, he's got the handles badges. That is nice. If he had Intimidator, I would like consider using it. Hey, he does have it on gold. Wow. This is actually a really nice looking card, this Nick Young. Good stuff. But now we move on to the best part of this video. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe you guys enjoy watching me waste packs or do other stuff. Anyways, 12-0. This is what we're talking about, bruh. Let me build you my lineup that we're gonna try to go 12-0 with. Now, like I mentioned, dude, I'm spending so much time on the spotlight challenges. I don't know when I'm actually gonna get to making a 12-0 run, and I'll probably lose a couple times, but at least this is a starting point, okay? This is where we're gonna start with our lineup. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be high overall. It's gonna be challenging, but you guys can give me suggestions, and we'll see if we need to pick up some other cards like that Eddie Curry eventually. But we'll start with our bench, okay? And our bench front court, because I already know this is easy. My boy Dino Radja at backup center. My boy Pascal Siakam, who I finally just unlocked at backup power forward. And the homie Billy Cunningham at backup small forward. That is a loaded front court off the bench. Now, Dino is still Dino. He is a stud, and he sells for about half the price of that new Eddie Curry. Now, like I mentioned, I'll probably upgrade to Curry, but for now, Dino, like, he's still so good. This Pascal card, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I haven't used him yet since I unlocked him, but he does have all the important badges. He's got 54 total badges, Hall of Fame range. Like, he should on paper still stack up. And in the first half of this year on my team, Diamond Pascal Siakam was one of my top 5 favorite cards. I love his jumper, so yeah, I gotta use him. Billy Cunningham, meanwhile, he is not as great as I thought he was gonna be. He moves a little bit slow, but he still is loaded with badges. He has a nice jump shot, so absolutely got to be in my lineup. Now, next up, I'm going to show you my starting front court, because actually the guard position in my lineups, they're kind of shaky, but the front court I really love, including our starters, Galaxy Opal Wilt Chamberlain, of course, the man they call Thurl Okungpo, yeah, Thurl Bailey, and my guy Opal James Worthy. Obviously Worthy and Wilt, like, they were 12-0 cards. We love them. James Worthy with base 11, he's just great. I love this card. Wilt's jump shot is so tough. Like, his ratings aren't great, his badges are okay, but his jumper is just, it's a little bit weird. But if I'm shooting a three-pointer with Wilt in an offensive possession, like, that possession has gone south, so I'm okay with that. He does everything else so well, and Thurl is an animal. There's a reason why we're comparing him to Giannis. But as for a backcourt, this is where I can tell my lineup's gonna be a little bit thin, but it's a lot of cards I really like. In the starters, I'm chucking in Nick Batum, yes, shout out to DBG, and I'm actually gonna run Bingo Smith at point guard, because I love this dude Bingo. Now, starting with Batum, what to love about him? He's a 6'9" shooting guard. I know everybody clowns DBG, and he probably overrates him a bit, but a ton of great Hall of Fame badges, and his three-point jump shot, his animation, like, it's amazing. Like, it's so hard not to green, so for me, spending 5K on a card like this, like, put him in my lineup, inject that into my veins every time. Bingo Smith, meanwhile, super underrated card in my opinion. He was free. He's 6'5", which means I'm good with having him at point guard. He has 30 Hall of Fame badges, including, pretty much everyone you want. The one problem with this card, he does have Hall of Fame glance. The one problem is his range extender is only on gold, but honestly, playing with him a ton in triple threat and a little bit in unlimited, it doesn't really affect him. Like, he's a beast. I love his jump shot. That's why he's there. And for our bench backcourt, I'm going with Rip Hamilton from the historic spotlights, and I'm sticking with Pink Diamond Jeremy Lin. Now, obviously, if I had unlimited MT and I wasn't worried about cards losing value, I would put in my guy Opal Chauncey Billups here, but Jeremy Lin, you know, 6'3", that's the one problem with him, but this card with his Evo is still a beast. 48 total Hall of Fame gold badges, and the ones he's got Hall of Fame, range extender, Deadeye, clamps, quick first step, they're all the important ones, so don't let that number fool you, even though it's a little bit low. As for Rip Hamilton, I'm super impressed with this card, man. I haven't played with him yet, I'll be honest, but badge wise 51 gold in Hall of Fame, and attributes wise yeah, he's stacked. He's got all the defensive badges. The only thing he's missing is, where is it, he's got clamps, is intimidator. I think he might have it on gold. Actually, I think he doesn't. That's why he's off the, oh, he does have it. So there you go. Rip does have pretty much every badge I need. And after we chuck in three bronzes off the bench, which we like to do, our lineup is a 94 overall. Now, to me, this lineup is really good. I feel confident, kind of, that I could beat whoever I face. Kinda. Now, the problem is 94 overall absolutely will get me playing guys with full Opal teams. Like, it is what it is. I might be facing, you know, Opal Ben Simmons, Opal T-Mac, Opal Kareem, whatever. And if the player is good at the game, those are games I lose. Like, I can't pretend like I'm the best player. I lose some of those games. But if we get favorable matchups against teams that are around my overall, this collection of pretty much all free players that I've grinded for, that, yeah, we've spent a little bit of MT on, I think I could beat anyone, which is the key to No Money Spent series. Now, I don't know when I'm gonna go 12-0. I'm not gonna start today because the streets are gonna be so sweaty, but if I can pull it off with this lineup, get that Glenn Rice, I would be one happy camper. Let me know what you guys think of my lineup, how I could improve it, what I could change, and yeah, go nuts in the comment section. I'm gonna pull one pack for the road, okay? One pack. For everyone that says I'm dumb for doing this, you are right, but we got one more pack, and I already know you're gonna like this video, you're gonna subscribe if you're new, okay? And I'm gonna just leave us with this one pack. Here we go. Flipping. Oh no, I'm not gonna flip all. I'm gonna score. Oh no, please don't.
Who was on crack?